Muscle spindles are the very specific tiny sensors present in the muscles, skeletal muscles. These fibers called intrafusal fibers runs parallelly to the skeletal muscle fibers in almost all skeletal muscles. So these sensors are dedicated to sense the length as well as tension in the muscles. So the extrafusal fibers or the contractile fibers or the skeletal muscles which generate the force, and the intrafusal fibers are nothing but muscle sensor or muscle spindles, or sense the muscle length and proprioception. So we have dynamic and static nuclear bag fibers where the sensor elevated at the central point, and some sensors are not elevated at central point, that is called nuclear chain fibers. The type 1A sensory fibers emerges from almost all nuclear bag and nuclear chain fibers and runs through the dorsal root ganglion, finally ends in the dorsal horn of the gray matter of the spinal cord, and some fibers ascend to the higher centers for the proprioception. Some fibers reverse back and innervates with the alpha motor neuron. And type 2 sensory fibers also emerges from the almost all the fibers, intrafusal fibers, except dynamic nuclear bag fibers. The type 2, the sensory fiber, also runs through the dorsal root ganglion and ends in the dorsal root gray horn. And the gamma motor neuron or fibers emerges from the anterior horn cell of the spinal cord and ends on either sides of the sensory receptors or intrafusal fibers, where they have the minor contractile elements. The gamma motor neuron innervates almost all nuclear bag and nuclear chain fibers at the terminal portions, which generates some action potential, and thereby the terminal portions would undergo contraction. So finally, the final common pathway, that is called alpha motor neuron, also emerges from the anterior horn cell of the spinal cord and innervates to the extrafusal muscles or fibers or skeletal muscles that already we discussed in the previous videos in the neuromuscle physiology. And the gamma and alpha motor neuron, of course, emerges from the anterior horn cell, intrafusal fibers and extrafusal fibers respectively. The skeletal muscle contraction can be possible by the three ways. One is direct stimulation of the alpha motor neuron, and we already have discussed the descending corticospinal tract, which ending on the alpha motor neuron, is the final common pathway to the skeletal muscle fiber or extrafusal muscle fibers. And there are two ways by which we can stimulate the muscles. These are the indirect ways. One is gamma motor neuron stimulation. As we know, the gamma motor neuron is supplying to the muscle spindle, the terminal portion of the muscle spindle, where the contractility of the muscle spindle or stretching of the muscle spindle upon gamma motor neuron, which brings about the afferent impulses in the type 1A and type 2 fiber, thereby the loop is ending on the anterior horn cell, that is alpha motor neuron, brings about the contraction. So the gamma motor neuron stimulation leads to the contraction of the extrafusal fibers through the stretching of the muscle spindle. And the second way of indirect stimulation of the stretching of the muscle itself, so especially seen in the clinical situation, by tapping on the any tendon, muscle tendon, would brings about the jerky response, contractile response, because of the stretch itself would initiate the afferent impulses through the 1A and 2 fibers and loop ending on the anterior horn cell, that is called alpha motor neuron, thereby the contraction is possible. And gymnastic maneuver is a kind of maneuver, clenching of the teeth and pulling of the hands, both hands apart by locking position, would improve the gamma motor neuron discharge, thereby the muscle spindle undergoes stretch, and the stretch initiates the contractility in the extrafusal fibers by stretching of the muscle spindles. So stretching of the muscle spindle or direct stimulation of the alpha motor neuron would brings about the contractility in the muscles or extrafusal muscles, which generates the force in the muscle fibers. And the muscle spindle functions, usually muscle spindle are the sensors which runs parallelly in the skeletal muscle. These sensors especially sense the muscle length during the dynamic action and during the static action. Mainly the muscle spindles are sensing the proprioception and maintenance of the balance, and the mainly type 1A fibers are the fibers which sense the dynamic response of the muscle length change, whereas type 2 fibers detect the static, the length of the muscle fiber, and the muscle spindle prevents the overstretching of the muscle in order to prevent the potential damage by overstretch. And muscle spindle also facilitate the all kinds of reflexes by the loop mechanism, and it also facilitate the withdrawal reflex in the during the pain or any painful stimulus.